first speaker today is representing Mrs. Horak's class, excuse me, Ms. Davis's class, Gabriella Thomas.
Hey, do you want to know about Harriet Tubman? Well, you're in luck, because I'm going to tell you about her and how she took a stand. Harriet Tubman was born in 1822 and was one of 11 children. Harriet Tubman was born a slave and was hired out by her master as a nursemaid for a small baby. Harriet Tubman did not go to school. Harriet Tubman was an Underground Railroad conductor. When she went through the Underground Railroad, she said to herself, "This is not enough. I need to help these people." And so she did. Harriet Tubman became an Underground Railroad conductor and helped people make their way free. Harriet Tubman contributed to the United States by becoming an Underground Railroad conductor, as I said earlier. It was important for her to become an Underground Railroad conductor because she helped people make their way to freedom. The United States without Harriet Tubman would have been harder because the Underground Railroad needs a conductor. I honestly really look up to Miss Harriet Tubman because she helps so many people make their way to freedom. To sum everything up, Harriet Tubman was one of 11 children, was born a slave, and was hired out by her master as a nursemaid for a small baby. Harriet Tubman had no education because she was always working. It was considerate of Miss Harriet Tubman to become an Underground Railroad conductor because she wanted to help people make their way to freedom. Harriet Tubman was such a brave and strong and helpful woman, but sadly, she passed away in 1913, March 10th. That will conclude my presentation.
Our next representing Mrs. Horak's class, Gabriella Camilla.
Harriet Tubman was born in 1820 or 1820 in Maryland. Her parents were Harriet Green and Benjamin Ross, and they were all owned by Edward Broda. He was a slave owner. Harriet was a sick child of 11 children, and the rest of her siblings were sold. Harriet was treated poorly. In 1844, Harriet married a free man named John Tubman. They lived near the Broda's plantation. She wanted to escape, and when it was time, Harriet ran to a house of a white woman who promised to help her. The woman would tell her the next house to go to. This was called the Underground Railroad. In each house was a safe house. The people who helped her believed slavery was wrong, and each house led her farther north to freedom. Harriet was hiding during the day and traveling at night. She finally reached Pennsylvania, where there was a law against slavery. Between 1850 and 1860, she worked as a cook, dishwasher, and clean. She saved her money to make 9 trips back to South to save 300 more slaves. Harriet would use songs to let the other slaves know it was safe to come out of hiding. Harriet was known as the conductor or Moses of her people. In 1858, Harriet met John Brown. He was a leader in the end slavery movement. In 1860, Abraham Lincoln was elected president and 11 states withdrew from the U.S. because Lincoln hated slavery and they didn't want him as their leader. April 12, 1861. The Civil War was going on, and Harriet worked as a nurse and a spy for the Northern Army. Harriet led hundreds more of slaves to freedom and took care of them during the fighting. In 1865, the Civil War ended, and an amendment to the Constitution was passed to end slavery. Harriet supported the suffragist movement, which was the fight for the woman to vote in the U.S. Harriet established a home in Auburn for the sick, poor, and homeless black people. Harriet moved into it in 1911. She was old and weak, and on March 10, 1913, she passed away. She was either 92 or 93 years old. Harriet was a very brave person to risk her life to save others.
All right, our next presenter.
Have you ever heard of the Seminole tribe? Well, they are one of the few tribes that still exist today. This is amazing considering all they went through. The Seminole tribe had to move a lot because the Europeans wanted their land. The group also faced many conflicts with the Europeans. The main reason why the Seminole tribe is still alive today is because they took a stand. In doing that, they were all needed. The Europeans wanted to find them, but because they were always moving, the Europeans could never find the Seminole tribe. Unfortunately, there are some tribes that do not exist any longer. One of those tribes is the Native American Dakota tribe known as the Tokobaga. Today I stand before you to take a stand for them. To begin, the Tokobaga tribe are amazing and need to be remembered for three main reasons. The first reason is their homes and environment. The homes and environment is very unique and special and very different from our homes. The homes and environment is very special because they have two different mounds, unlike other Native American Florida tribes. One mound is for the Chief Solomon tribe's temple, and the other mound is for burying the dead, which is far away from their villages, which who can blame them? They also have something called middens. Middens are large piles of clam shells and other seafood scraps. The midden is located right next to the kitchen as a garbage can for seafood. The biggest thing that makes them different is that they are a very calm and peaceful tribe, unlike the Appalachians. To continue, the second way the Tokobaga Native Americans are unique is their tools and methods they use for hunting and digging. One of the methods they use for hunting is disguising as an animal when they hunt. The Tokobaga tribe disguises themselves with any kind of animal food to get close enough to the animals to kill them. Another tool they use to hunt animals is a tool they make called the adze. The adze is like a spear and is made by tying a sharp shell or rock to the end of a sturdy tree branch. The tool they use for digging is called an adze. The adze is made by making a hole in a tree branch and putting a sharp shell or rock in the hole and waiting for the tree branch to grow around it. Finally, the third thing that makes the Tokobaga tribe unique is the food they ate. The Tokobaga tribe has a balanced diet because they always have some kind of meat as a main portion and a fruit or vegetable as a side. The options for the main portions are shellfish, fish, manatees, deer, armadillo, and squirrel. The options for the sides are berries, nuts, fruit, and corn. In conclusion, the Native American tribe Tokobagas were phenomenally special and different compared to all the other tribes. That's because how they hunt, what they ate, and their environment. Don't let tribes like these be removed from history. May they live in our hearts forever.
Around
around the world, there is a problem with a pregnancy or childbirth that can be harmful or even lead to death. Would you help prevent almost 90% of this if you could? Ann Geddes took a stand and became an advocate to reduce the amount of preventable deaths among women and children. She was the ambassador to the March for Dimes charity in 2014. According to my online searches, one of her most iconic images was a photo of the smallest baby she'd ever photographed, weighing only 2 2/10 pounds. To conclude, Ann has by far transformed photography with her iconic images of babies enveloped in flowers, sleeping peacefully, or even fluttering in fairy wings. With Ann's belief that every baby should be protected, nurtured, and loved has allowed her to take a stand and contribute to the world in positive ways. So what can you do to take a stand?
Do you know Rosa Parks, Abraham Lincoln? You probably do. There are thousands of people in history who have taken a stand. But guess what? A girl that went to this school took a decisive stand, and her name is Madison Rowe. She took a stand against bullies when she was just 9 years old. Madison created Cub and got a grant to paint a mural. Madison is 13 years old. She was born on January 27, 2005 in New Jersey, Florida. She's in 7th grade at Colf Middle School. Madison loves to compliment others. She had said, "I love to compliment people because it brightens up their day and makes them feel good inside with a smile." In her free time, when she isn't standing up against bullies or doing charity work, she likes to play soccer and hang out with her friends. I mean, who doesn't? Madison decided to make a club at Casey Elementary, which is where she went to school at the time. Madison got the club idea from a Disney commercial making a difference. And she thought an anti-bully club would make a difference. Madison had said, "I don't refer the club to an anti-bully club. I like it as the Hero Club." She said Hero Club because it stands for helping everyone respect others. Madison had then asked the principal if she could start the club. She said yes. The club then started every other Thursday morning with Madison and her club discussing why bullying happens and how to be a great friend. Her club even made bracelets, t-shirts, and graduate cans because we are linked together. Madison also created a positive bucket and a negative bucket. When you did a kind deed or gave out a compliment, you filled up your positive bucket. With everything her and her club were doing, she needed a project for them. So she applied for a $500 Disney Friends for Change grant. She got the grant. Madison still needed a paper project. So she baked a mural. This mural will have balloons on it. She liked the balloons because the theme was "Words Lift You Up." The mural was painted April 17th through the 19th. The wonderful bright balloons also had kind, inspiring words on each individual one. The words anybody of everybody could read when they walked by. Madison is more than just a girl. She's an inspiring, powerful, young lady who tries hard every day to help people out. What Madison has done has changed others' lives. When Madison took a stand, she was 9 years old, and most of the guys are older than that. So I hope this speech encourages you to take a stand. It could be as small as picking up litter around the park, but at least you did something.
Everybody, a big hand. It's been awesome. One of the hardest things that we can do as felt the need of as adults is to get up and perform or present in front of our peers. I'm sure a lot of you have had that experience through TEDx or other presentations, and you know that feeling it gives you, so it's really hard. So one of the great skills you can do, though, is to practice that and get better and better, because as you can get stronger at presenting and giving information, the more opportunities open up to you as you get older. So not only did they do a great job putting together their presentations today, but also overcoming that fear and that feeling we get in front of others. Because even as adults, we still get those feelings. We find ways to get past it, and you all did an awesome job with that, so you should be proud of yourselves.
I know that you are anxious and excited to find out who is our first place that's going on to represent our school, but we do have to tell you that the speeches were so great, we actually have a tie for our first place. Oh. Here is how we are going to handle this tie. I'm going to tell you who are the top two, and then we have video of the performances, and we will have some other people that were not in here watch the video with the score and scale. The two that were a tie both got a perfect score. Okay. So the two that have a tie are Lily Wood. Celebrating all five of our speakers because they were awesome.